What's up, guys? My name is Hans Rogers, and today we're gonna do a video with this board right here. So we're gonna do 15 tricks on a pintail longboard, because a lot of people have been asking me about this. Like, they're saying, oh, I got a board for a present or whatever. It's a pintail, it doesn't look like your board. Can I do tricks with it? And I'm here to tell you, for sure, you can do a lot of tricks with it. So I'm gonna go over 15 tricks that are pretty basic and are some like all kinds of tricks, so you have some inspiration to try tricks. Go out, have fun with the boards, because that's what it's all about, of course. These tricks also work for all kinds of boards. Today we're gonna specifically talk about pintail, kind of like surfboard shaped longboards. It's really old school like shapes, so we're also gonna be focusing on some old school tricks, etc. I think it's really fits the style of the board, and it looks super cool if you do some tricks like cross steps on this type of board. I'm not gonna go in depth on all of these, but I'm gonna link some videos down below that do have some in-depth trick tips for some of these tricks. A lot of these tricks, actually, so if you wanna learn more about them, check it out. And yeah, let's get started. All right, so for the first trick, we're gonna do a fakie pivot. You can also do this nollie. If you don't know what these two words mean, check out the video right here. I explain all about it right there. And a fakie pivot is super crucial if you have a pintail. I recommend trying it for the first trick you do. You have like one big tail and one small tail. So sometimes you might be cruising like in the wrong direction and you want to turn your board around. So you can do this very easily if you're able to do a pivot. If you want to turn around, if you want to make turns, whatever. If you're riding in one direction, cruising on the beach, and then you have to stop and go back home, then you do a pivot and your board is in the right direction. That's super crucial if you don't have a symmetrical board. Yeah, that's why we're gonna do a pivot first. Next up, we're gonna do a cross step, because hell yeah, if you have a pintail, you gotta be able to do cross steps, because it just looks awesome. It's a surf trick, it's a surf board, so cross steps are super fun to do on a board like this, especially because they have a little flex most of the time, and it just looks easy as fuck, so here are cross steps. Next up, we're gonna do a pirouette. So pirouette or pirouette, it's just a 360 when you spin around with one foot on the board still. It's kind of like a ballerina move. But it's also something that looks very stylish, especially on a board like this. It's a really basic one and you can practice it standing still. Also on your board if you flip your board. But you can do it like this. You can really practice it like that. It's no risk. Yeah, you can get that confidence of getting the turn in, and then you're good to go on the board. Next up is a look back. So this is a super old school trick back from the Adam and Adam days. And yeah, it's super fun. It's a really basic one. So the look back, you can do it in all kinds of ways. So I'm not gonna restrict it for one way or another. Also gonna show you a couple of ways how you can do it. You can do it with the body varial, without a body varial, fakie nollie, switch, whatever, however you wanna do it. A really fun trick to get creative with and just mess around on the board and have fun.
Tiger claw.
A Okay, so Tiger Claw, it's a hand trick. It's a really good trick to get started. If you're not confident on your board yet, but you want to do some tricks, it's a really fun one because there's a low risk of falling too for this one. Whew, you gotta catch your breath from that windmill. So because of the fact that you're standing on the ground, so you're doing two steps while you do the trick, there's a lower risk of falling, which is good for beginner tricks. Yeah, we don't want to fall. Don't feel bad if you still fall. I still fall like crazy. The point is, Tiger Claw, fun trick. And it also enhances the style of the board because it's like smooth. Woo, I can see myself doing it, riding on the beach, you know? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we can all picture it. Yeah, that would be cool. Now we're doing it here in the cold winter of Belgium. Yeah, but anyways, Tiger Claws. Hell yeah.
Doe nog maar.
We're gonna do manuals. It's probably the favorite, my favorite thing to do if I'm just cruising around with friends or, oh god damn it, my stamina really went down because of exams. As I was saying, manuals are super fun to do if you're just cruising around for A to B. And yeah, it's no effort, you're just popping a little manual. It's not really a trick, but it will require a lot of practicing. You can't just be out here and learn how to do a proper manual in one day. It's just a matter of practicing a lot. If you're cruising around every time, try a little manual, just have fun with it. Don't force it. Don't be out here like, oh, I have to try this manual, I have to learn it right now, if I don't, I'm failure. Whatever, it's not that case. Just have fun with it. Throughout time, you will find yourself being able to do it longer and longer, and just like that, you'll be able to do some fun manuals. And moving on to the next trick, we're gonna do a nose manual.
Nose manual.
So for nose manual, it's also a manual, so it also requires a lot of practicing. Me, myself, I really sucked.
Yeah.
Me, myself. I really sucked at doing nose manuals because I always thought you had to do a fakie. If you do it fakie, then it's a switch nose manual, kinda. I recommend trying a naughty, it's easier because then it's way easier to balance. First of all, I recommend doing it on the tail because you have more space to put your feet. And I recommend you putting your foot like kinda on the X, but also a bit to the front on the nose itself. You have to like kinda feel what feels right for you. The back foot mostly goes somewhere over here for me. So it's kinda like this position. We're gonna bend through our knee, put our shoulders and our arms up so you have more balance, like this. And then we're gonna go through our front knee. Tail is going up. And then we're gonna find our balance in that position. Our back foot doesn't really matter that much, how it's positioned, because that foot is only used to kind of like balance the board, keep it stable. You don't wanna put too much pressure on anything. Just really find that sweet spot of balance. Just a lot of practice. Ghost ride kickflip. So for the next trick, we're gonna do the ghost ride kickflip, which is a really basic trick. It's a really fun one for beginners. And it's also something that really suits the style of the board. So go out and have fun with it. Next up, we're gonna do a hippie jump. Woo! A hippie jump is pretty much if you just jump over something, your board goes under it, and you get back to landing on it. Now, there are a couple of factors that play a role in this trick. First of all, you gotta be able to jump over it, so you need some upwards jumping power. It really helps that these pintails often have some flex in it, so it's easier to jump and it's easier to land because it flexes. If you're over it, you often find yourself jumping and the board is back. It just stops when you're jumping. If that's the case, I really recommend just practicing it, not jumping over something, because then you will automatically kind of like jump forward and leave your board behind. Figure out how to jump and keep your board under yourself. This is a really fun one if you find some weird ass benches or whatever and you can hippie jump over them. Really fun. There you go. Okay, next up is a fakie shove it. This is a really fun trick. It was pretty much my second trick after a fakie pivot. You can also do them naughty, of course. So fakie shove it, kind of like a pivot. You start with the same thing, make a pivot, and then just at the end of the pivot, keep your shoulders straight and then jump. And just like that, it's really easy to learn fake your naughty shove it. Here are some demonstrations. Next up, we're gonna do a Peter Pan.
Yeah, got it.
So this is a super fun dancing step, really basic as well. It's a really fun one, I really recommend, because this is like one of the fundamentals for a lot of dancing steps, and it's really fun to do on a pintail. Next up is a boneless. Whoa, got him. So for a boneless, you've probably seen it in a lot of the old school videos, like the original videos in Barcelona, etc. And it's still one of the tricks that if you can do it right, it looks fantastic. So one of those tease tricks, and I really recommend you checking it out. Next up, we're gonna do an old school flip. Old school flip is more of a pretty advanced trick, but it's something that suits this board so well. I just have to put it on this list. Super chill because most of the pintails like flex a bit, so it's really ideal for old school flips. So yeah, here they are. The trick prochain is a 180 step. So 180 steps are really fun, really just chill to do, cruising. If you combine it with a switch 180 step or with other dance tricks, it's super smooth. So that's why you're already 180 steps. So for the last trick, I just have to put this trick in here because it's probably my favorite trick. No comply. So no comply is really a chill trick once you get the hang of it. It's pretty difficult to learn at first, but it's super worth it once you're able to do it. Also put a link to the trick tip down below. And yeah, it's my favorite trick by far. Super chill to do, cruising around or whatever. Looks hella cool, old school as fuck. Yeah, it's just a perfect trick to end this list. Thank you. Alright guys, so those are 15 tricks on a pintail longboard. Hope you get something out of it. Hope you feel somewhat inspired to go out and have fun on your board, because that's what it's all about, man. Just have fun. It's a super fun board. I had an awesome time just making this video and skating this, because it's something else that I'm used to. But it's super smooth, it's super fun to cruise around on. And I really enjoyed dancing on it and doing these tricks. So hope you enjoyed as well. Have fun on them. I'll leave all the trick tips on these tricks down below. So be sure to subscribe if you're new here. I make a lot of videos like this. Tips videos, also just full on longboard videos, vlogs, whatever. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching. Big hugs from Belgium. And see you guys in the next one. Ciao.